His chase led him to a golden palace east of the sun and west of the moon. Even then, his logic remained sound. He knew the world was all in his imagination. But he was so proud of having created it. In his own eyes, he'd become something greater than a king. For someone who'd never known success in the real world, I think it was overwhelming. And then it struck him that the real Lewis was not the one chopping salmon, but the one climbing the steps of a golden palace. "My imagination is as real as my body," he told me. It was hard to argue with him. Began to forget the world we know. I think it pained him to remember Lewis, the cannery worker. He began to despise the man with a royal contempt. I still thought I could save him. Even after he said he was being crowned king over all the lands of wonder, the palace would be packed with his companions. Including the wise Calico who'd insisted on inviting them. I think you know. Mrs. Finch, your son was a kind man who will be missed by all of us who knew him.
My brother was really cool. I wish you could have met him.